spoke to Bill Snyder about his offensive plan against North Texas, and he certainly wants to build on last week's showing against Miami, where Colin Klein completed 82% of his passes. But he told me, hey, it's not going to be a predictable offense as usual. Bill Snyder's offense never is. Now, Dan McCourney, all too familiar with Bill Snyder's unpredictable offense, said his North Texas defense has to be the best tackling defense in college football tonight. He's looking for some confidence from his team, Mike.
Well, okay, Laura, thank you so much. And certainly they're going to need it against a very good Kansas State team. I think a lot of people were not surprised that they beat Miami, but how convincingly they did.
Yeah, and for both teams tonight, this is one of those games where you tighten your chin strap a little tighter, you tighten your shoulder pads a little tighter, and you tape up a little tighter, because both of these teams like to play physical football.
Tyler Lockett is back to receive the kickoff. He is about as dangerous as anybody in the nation. Not going to be able to take it out here, as the Wildcats will have it first and 10 from the 25-yard line. Colin Klein, one of the more unique quarterbacks in all of college football. 27 rushing touchdowns last season. He carried the ball over 300 times to lead the way in the Big 12.
Yeah, that's a lot of carries and a lot of punishment. And he admitted to us that later in the season, he really started to feel some of those hits. But, you know, they've got to work on their passing game. He's got to be a little more balanced. And I know he's worked on it all spring and all summer. Had a great game last week against Miami throwing the ball. Needs to continue to develop and work that game.
Wide under center. John Hubert, they're leading back behind him. And on first down, they'll go to the air. And he throws it wide, intended for Chris Harper. Our Academy Sports and Outdoors Right Stuff player, John Hubert.
Yeah, John Hubert off to a great start this season, averaging 129 yards, rushing a game. And with he and Colin Klein both in the backfield together, I mean, they really help each other, because a defense doesn't know which guy they can really key on. So with Hubert running the ball as well as he is, really helps Colin Klein and vice versa.
He was second in the Big 12 in rushing last season, was Hubert. And they'll feed him here. Straight ahead running between the tackles. Gain of about 5, and he'll set up third down and manageable for this K-State offense.
You know, defensively for North Texas, their biggest thing is they just want to be physical up front, and they've got to tackle well. That's the thing that they have to do against this Kansas State offense, is you got to tackle well. You can't miss tackles against these guys, because there's too many weapons out there. The biggest thing for them is to limit yards after contact.
Klein going to work out of the gun on third down and 5. He'll tuck it and run. And a nice job by North Texas. Just a couple on the pick of Zachary Orr, the middle linebacker, an all Sun Belt performer a year ago.
Yeah, do a good job of just attacking. They bring Zach Orr around and gets right in the face of Colin Klein. And that was a designed quarterback run anyway. But they understand that North Texas knows what Kansas State likes to do in that situation. So they brought pressure in the run blitz.
Ryan Dorr, one of the better punters in the Big 12. They always seem to have great special teams under Bill Snyder. And gets off a good one here. It'll take a bounce. And Wayne State will cover it at the 22-yard line. So that'll give us our first look at the offense for North Texas, led by Derek Thompson. You heard JC in the open mention he's got to improve his accuracy. 56% for his career, but this season under 50%. They run the ball very well, but obviously there's going to be some third and longs today.
Yeah, he's misfired on a lot of throws in the first couple of weeks, and they know that he's capable of making those. And so they felt like that he was going to come out here today and be more accurate and better. And he's going to have to be, because it's going to be tough to run against Kansas State. They're going to have to make some big plays through the air.
They start off two tight ends. And to the ground, and a big gaping hole, and firing right through it is number 24, Brandon Byrd, the junior. Our Academy Sports and Outdoors Right Stuff player for North Texas.
Yeah, and Brandon Byrd, he's their leading rusher. Had 136 yards rushing last week against Texas Southern. we've been talking about Thompson having to make some throws through the air, but Bird is the guy that has to get it going on the ground.
Bird behind Thompson. This is second and three. Probes the left side, nothing doing. Three, four, five purple jerseys on the stop, including John Sua, the big defensive tackle, number 96. Let's take a look at the keys to the game for the Mean Green.
Well, we've been talking about it already. They've got to be efficient in their passing game and make some plays through the air with Derek Thompson. And then defensively, I talked about in that first series, they've got to tackle well, and they did that first drive defensively.
On third and two, Wildcats rushing four. Dangerous pass caught in traffic and then knocked out of bounds is Bird.
Wow, very lucky that that ball didn't get picked off.
And the Mean Green will have to punt it away. Will Atterbury, the senior out of Louisville, Texas, on the punt. K-State not only good at returning kickoffs, but they got a pretty good punt returner in that man, Tremaine Thompson. High spiraling kick. And a fair catch called for at the 27-yard line by Thompson. We'll get our second look at Colin Klein and the Wildcats offense when we return. No score here from Manhattan. .27 to play in the first quarter. No score here from Manhattan, Kansas. A capacity crowd at beautiful Bill Snyder Family Stadium. Mike Morgan alongside J.C. Pearson, as well as Laura McKeeman down on the sideline. Second drive for that man, Colin Klein and company. First down, back to the ground game, and a modest gain for John Huber. As we welcome those of you who were watching Texas A&M battle SMU, 48-3, the final score there. The Aggies picking up the win over June Jones and company. We're in the early going of the first quarter here. Kansas State on its second drive. Nobody able to march the ball down the field as of yet. Kansas State coming in with a big win last week against the Miami Hurricanes. They have tallied more than 50 points in their first two games. On second and nine, Klein, little option. Ball is loose on the ground. And squirts out of bounds. Klein was the last one to touch it. Almost a huge turnover there. Would have been a big break for North Texas. As it stands, it'll be a loss of nearly 10.
Yeah, pitch on that option was just a little bit behind John Huber. You want to get that pitch out in front so that he can catch it as he's running, but you'll see when the pitch comes, just hits Hubert on the back shoulder. You'll see it's on the back shoulder, Huber not able to pull that thing in, and Kansas State avoids it. It would have been a huge turnover for them.
Now the Wildcats need the 37 for the first down. All kinds of time for Klein, has a man open and just out of the reach of Chris Harper, the former Oregon Duck.
That's right there is what people question about Colin Klein. They know that he can run the ball and he's a big, strong kid. He's got plenty of time in the pocket, sets his feet, but then the ball just kind of sails. You can see his throwing motion is still just doesn't seem like it's real fluid. The ball just sails on him. That's a ball that needs to be completed because he had enough time in the pocket. He's got a man wide open. Got to be able to hit those.
Ryan Doron for the second time. Another good strong kick. Bounces at the 45, and that's where North Texas will take over. Good field position for the Mean Green. 35-yard putt. No return. We'll see more of Derek Thompson at North Texas when we return from Manhattan. would not want to have to game plan that West Virginia offense. Geno Smith, Tavon Austin, they have got some weapons.
They've got some firepower out there. Second year Dana Holgorsen.
Little shovel pass to Bird, and Bird trots ahead for 9.
I tell you, North Texas, they've come in here ready to play. You know, and when we talked to Coach McCarney, that's what he wanted to see from his kids. He just wanted guys to come out and play hard every play. He didn't think that they would be intimidated. Obviously, they opened against LSU at LSU in front of 92,000 fans. So he didn't think that his kids would come in here and be intimidated, and obviously they're not.
And a whistle will stop play, a timeout here called by Coach McCarney.
That is their first timeout of the first half.
First timeout of the game with 9:28 to play in the first quarter. Watch Dan McCarney. Doesn't like what he sees. Hustle up there. Get that T.O. 9:28 to play first quarter. A scoreless game thus far here from Manhattan, Kansas. As you see, Dan McCarney strolling along the sideline. He did a terrific job at Iowa State. Led the Cyclones to 5 bowl games. A lot of people were frankly mystified why he didn't keep his job there. A great opportunity here at North Texas and a chance to put this program on the map. Good power running straight up the gut by Brandon Bird, and that'll move the chains after a 5-yard pickup. McCarney also a longtime assistant coach under Hayden Fry. And he won a national title as a defensive line coach with the Florida Gators back in 2008. Really, everywhere he's been, there has been success that has followed in one way or another. And I know North Texas, talking to the folks around this program, are very happy to have him as the head coach.
No question. Won 5 ball games last year. Had to completely build this program from scratch, and done a great job so far.
Bird trying to bust out of an ankle tackle. Gobbles up about 3 more. I'll tell you what, JC, the thing that sticks out to me so far in the early going, some of the holes produced by that mean green offensive line.
Yeah, their offensive line is playing very well. I mean, they haven't allowed a sack yet this year or have had a penalty. And you're talking about they went down to play LSU week 1, didn't give up a sack and not one penalty on the offensive line. They're playing as well as you can play so far this year.
Thompson out of the gun on 2nd down. Pass is caught. That's Ivan Delgado. And he'll be about a yard short of the first down.
Cyril Lemon right there, the right guard. He's the best of the bunch up there. Look at his feet. Look at his footwork, and that's a big guy right there, 321 pounds. That's what they like about their offensive linemen, is that they're big and they're athletic. They can move, they can pull, they do a lot of things. Obviously, they run the ball, they're very aggressive. That's what they do. He likes those guys to be physical up front.
They'll need to be physical here, 3rd and short. And keeping those legs grinding is Brandon Bird, and looks like he's got it. Just enough surge for that offensive line.
Yeah, going right behind Cyril Lemon again, number 62. You see him just comes off, doesn't get a great block, but creates just enough of a hole to allow Brandon Bird to get up the field. Not enough for a first down, but now it's 4th and inches.
They need about a chain link. Bird again, and this time there's no doubt about it. Brandon Bird, the junior, 5'10", 216 pounds, gallops for 5.
You know, Mike, this Kansas State football team just doesn't look like the same team that was playing last week against Miami. You know, typically they're slow starters, and they started slow in their first game against Missouri State. But last week against Miami, they came out, and they were intense from the opening kickoff on, you know, offense and defense, and they just don't look right now like they have that same intensity.
North Texas trying to take advantage of that. This time, Bird is stacked up. Picked up a couple, but number four, Arthur Brown, one of the best linebackers in college football on the stop.
Arthur Brown playing that inside linebacker spot. Does a great job just reading the play, fights off of a blocker and just reads the ball carrier and fills the hole. I mean, Arthur Brown is the leader of this Kansas State defense, the emotional guy, and he needs to get these guys to pick it up.
Former Miami Hurricane Arthur Brown, now back in his home state of Kansas. Seventh play of the drive on second and long. Pass complete at the 20. Breaking two tackles, finally Brown wrestling Chancellor down to the turf. Breland Chancellor, easily their best wideout, the guy that can make some plays. You see Brown on the ground.
Yeah, he's going to have to come out of the game. Unfortunate, that would be a huge loss for Kansas State. But, you know, going back to talking about them being emotionally ready and intense, after coming off a huge win against Miami, the way they played, and then obviously, you know, we talked to the players. They know what's coming up next week. The big showdown with Oklahoma. So it's easy to see how they might have a letdown early here against North Texas.
News is good for that young man, Arthur Brown, on that last play, got kind of twisted up in a pile, and you'll keep an eye on that right ankle. Right at the bottom of the pile, and you see all the weight coming down on him, and that ankle forced to go in a direction it's not supposed to.
Yeah, gets tough because he gets caught up, and then now all the momentum and the weight from the other players coming in to help make the tackle, he gets that right ankle caught underneath him.
Arthur Brown means so much to that defense. All Big 12 first team a year ago, defensive newcomer of the year in the Big 12, and as JC mentioned, one of the leaders of that unit. Minus one for Kansas State, who on the main green trying to tack on a yard here on third and short. Tap dancing and finally surging ahead is Jeremy Brown, the senior, and that should be good for a first down.
And how about North Texas? Nothing fancy for them. They're coming out and they're basically running the same play over and over, that inside power, and just continuing to gain yards on it. I thought it would be much tougher for those guys to run against this Kansas State defense, but you know, North Texas up front doing a great job so far, just winning the battle at the line of scrimmage.
Impressive drive continues for the main green. On first down, Thompson, all kinds of time, delivers a strike, and that'll be complete for an 8-yard pickup to Delgado, his second grab of the drive.
And that's the way they like to play. They like to run, and then play action, because look at the fake on the run, and now he's got all the time he needs to survey the field. Delgado just comes up and stops, and got plenty of time to find him. Number one, because their offensive line is doing a great job, and number two is because of the way that they're running the football, that play action froze the defense.
Very methodical drive for North Texas, just the way they like it. Second and short, and a touchdown.
They fooled everybody.
Chancellor, where did that come from? Breland Chancellor. A little trickery here from the mean green.
And not really any trickery. I mean, they ran this play earlier, but they faked it to Chancellor and ran the inside lead. This time they handed to Chancellor on the jet sweep. And it seemed like K-State never even thought that there was an opportunity for him to get the ball. They just let him go.
The first touchdown of the year for Chancellor. First rushing touchdown of the season for Chancellor, the wideout.
I mean, just a jet sweep, just a basic play. He's going to come in motion. They're going to hand it to him. They just seal on the outside, and there's nobody out there.
It's not supposed to look this easy.
No, but watch them seal the edge. Great block there. The receiver comes down, and he seals the safety, and it's too easy. Watch right here. Watch him seal the edges. Great job up front sealing, And it's like Kansas State was missing a player on that side. I don't know where the corner was on that side, but normally that's going to be an unblocked guy that can make the tackle.
Well, the scoring drive, the BMW ultimate drive. How about this? 11 plays, 55 yards, 6:05 off the clock, and the touchdown on a play in which Kansas State looked frozen.
Yeah. Looked like they hadn't seen that play before.
I was watching everybody stand still. I thought maybe there was a penalty flag. Yeah, something just didn't seem right.
Yeah, that's what it looked like. It looked like they were just standing around and didn't know what to do. I thought it might have been a penalty myself.
Well, the Wildcats have certainly received a wake-up call here in the first quarter. Lockett from the four. Lockett with a seam. Lockett down the sideline. One man to beat. Touchdown, Kansas State, 96 yards. He set a Big 12 record a year ago with over 35 yards of return, and he comes up big on this one.
And just a great job of blocking it. Had a left return set up, and he was able to get there. And then the rest is just speed. It was blocked perfectly by that K-State kickoff return team.
They do it so well. Year in, year out, one of the top special teams in all of college football. Extra point up and good by Cantelli.
And this is what Tyler Lockett does best. This is where he made his name last year. Now watch him go to the left. Look at the wall right there. Everybody going left, and then that's going to allow him to get to the edge. And once he gets there, look, great block. Seal here, block there, and then look at the room he has to run. And once he gets outside, he's got a lot of speed, and if you don't take the right angle, you're not going to catch him.
You see 86 Tremaine Thompson doing just a little bit of extra insurance on the seal off of the punter.
Yeah, great job by the wall initially, just giving him a lane, and then with him with his vision and speed just gets to the corner, and he's just untouched. But that's something that they work on. Special teams here at Kansas State, they put as much emphasis on that, and you hear all teams talk about it.
Right.
But they actually put the time and the effort in to make that special as much as they do offense and defense.
And that number is not a coincidence. Kansas State since 1999, the most non-offensive touchdowns in all of college football. Everybody hears about Frank Beamer and the terrific job that they do with special teams at Virginia Tech. Not far behind, maybe even better in some cases, Bill Snyder, how they preach it and how they execute it. Dean Green on the return is Chancellor. Chancellor reversing field. Still on his feet at the 25 and finally brought down to the 29-yard line. Let's check in with Laura McKeeman.
Mike, Arthur Brown for Kansas State, obviously a crucial player on their defense. He's been grimacing in pain as they've been trying to check out that right ankle and see what they can find out about it. A lot of shaking his head no, which probably means it doesn't feel very good. Then he stood up and was able to walk along the sideline a little bit, also raising his heels up and down to see if he has that range of motion. We'll see what he's able to do for the rest of this game, but that would be a crucial loss for Kansas State if he can't get back in.
No question about it. He is the architect of that defense now in his senior year. Again, they've got a big one coming up next week against Oklahoma. You don't want an injured Arthur Brown for that game. Crowd back into it now with 3:35 to play first quarter. Thompson throws it away. This Kansas State secondary, one of the tops in the Big 12. Last year they had 18 interceptions. Ty Zimmerman, Nigel Malone, number 24, two of the best you'll see.
They've given up some yards though in the back end. They've been tough to run against. The teams have tried to throw against them. They've had some success, but like you said, Nigel Malone, one of the best corners in the Big 12. Typically, they try to stay away from him, number 21.
On second and 10, rifles it complete at the 35, and a great second effort by Delgado. Give him 11 and give the Mean Green a first down.
Derek Thompson throwing the ball pretty well so far in this game. And we talked about him having to throw the ball well. You see Delgado, number 10, just nothing fancy, just comes up 6-7 yards and turns around, sits in the hole in the zone. It's a nice, quick, easy throw for Thompson.
Bird the lone back on first down. Gets it, and he is lassoed down behind the line of scrimmage. No chance to go anywhere on that one. Williams in the backfield on a tackle.
Yeah, Meshack Williams going to be down here, number 42. Comes up and really just kind of fell into that play. He was chasing the quarterback and played run on the way to the quarterback and came up with the big tackle for loss.
Meshack Williams and Adam Davis, the two bookends on that Kansas State defensive line. Five wide on second and 13. Look out. Pass complete at the 40. And a nice pickup for Delgado already with four catches. Gobbles up 10. I'll tell you, JC, so far I'm impressed with what I see out of this North Texas offense.
Absolutely. Mixing things up a little bit, but nothing fancy. I mean, we thought that they were going to come in and have to be gimmicky and gadget plays. They haven't had to do any of that. They're lining up, running their offense, and having a lot of success doing it.
Third down and 4. Wildcats bring the blitz. And again caught by Ivan Delgado. Wow, he came into this game with 3 catches on the season. He's already got 5.
And great job by Derek Thompson. Recognizes the pressure that's coming. And right now just gets the ball out of his hands to Delgado outside. So even though Kansas State brought 5 guys to try to get to him, didn't have enough time. Got rid of the ball. Great recognition.
Down to the ground and firing through the hole is Brandon Bird. He'll pick up 4 as we're under a minute to go in the first quarter. 7-7 our score. Thompson 8 of 9 through the air. Brandon Bird has gotten it done on the ground. And the Mean Green have been very productive thus far on the offensive side of the ball.
And they're controlling the clock. That's what they wanted to do. They wanted to come out, said they wanted to win the time of possession battle, keep Colin Klein in that offense on the sideline, and they've been able to do that.
They're beating K-State at their own game in that respect. Normally the Wildcats control time of possession. Nice hole up the middle again on second down. This time it's the freshman Jimerson. And that might be the final play of quarter number 1. If it wasn't for Tyler Lockett and a 96-yard kickoff return, North Texas would have this first quarter dominated in some respects. As it stands, they'll be happy to take a 7-7 tie into the second quarter. It'll be North Texas football when we return. 7-7 our score. Here from Bill Snyder Family Stadium, you're watching Fox College Football. It's 4th in the nation.
That's how you stop Colin Klein. If you want to know how to stop him, keep him on the sideline and have your offense dominate the time of possession. That's what North Texas is definitely doing right now.
5 wide on 3rd and 2. Over the middle, complete. First down at the 35. Another methodical drive now for North Texas as Chancellor hauls it in for 4.
Derek Thompson doing a great job. We talked about it in the open, how he was going to have to play better than he's played the first couple of games. Definitely doing that. Spreading the ball around, keeping his eyes down the field, getting it out of his hands so that that Kansas State rush doesn't have time to get to him, and just continuing to get first downs.
Little toss play to the right. Look at that second and third effort by Jimerson, the freshman, talking about keeping those legs churning.
Not only that, just the patience. Watch him slow down. Initially, he got out in front of his blockers, and he had to slow down, get behind his blockers again, and then try to jump back outside and find a crease. Look at him jump back behind, allow those guys to get a block for him, and then able to get down the field. You don't see that from a lot of freshmen. A lot of freshmen, they panic. They just get the ball and try to run fast. But sometimes you have to allow your blockers time to set up.
On second down, back to the ground game. This time it's Jimerson again for a short game. Let's check in down to the field with Laura.
Mike, you may be wondering why North Texas head coach Dan McCarney is wearing sunglasses at night. Turns out his right eye is blind and actually had to be replaced. So he has a new eye in there that's a glass eye, and it's a little bit misshaped and sensitive to light, so he wears those sunglasses. He's recovering from this, and this injury occurred actually in Gainesville at Florida because he was exposed to so much sun.
Very similar to Chuck Amato during his days as the head coach at NC State.
Looks good, though.
Yeah. Fashion statement of sorts. On third and short, in trouble and sacked at the 40-yard line. Kansas State finally got to him. Ryan Muller, the sophomore out of Leawood, Kansas.
And that's the first mistake that Thompson has made. You got to get rid of that football. You can't take that loss. And now you knock your team out of possible field goal range or out of possibly doing again. You can see right here. Wow, look at that. Got away with the face mask there. But you got to get rid of that football.
And to your point, JC, they've got a kicker in Zach Olin, who already in his career has hit three field goals from beyond 50 yards.
Yeah, so they had a chance at some points there. You got to get rid of the ball, not take that loss.
Penalty flag looked like the play clock ran down.
Live game, offense number 41, 5-yard penalty, still fourth down.
Really doesn't hurt you too much where they are. Atterbury can certainly deliver it where he needs to, 5 yards back. A lone score today for Kansas State coming on special teams. Tyler Lockett, the All-American return man, taking a kickoff back for 96 yards. And they will decline the penalty. Incidentally, North Texas already with 7 first downs. Kansas State looking for its first. Didn't think we'd say that in the second quarter.
No. It's hard to make a first down when you're on the sideline.
A directional punt. Looked pretty good. Out of bounds, unreturnable. And inside the 10, exactly what the Mean Green wanted. 12-16 remaining. A tie ball game here from Manhattan, Kansas. Kansas State offense has been stymied. Colin Klein a little bit frustrated in the early going. Back with you from the Heartland, 7-7 our score with 12-16 remaining in the first half. Colin Klein with just 3 total yards of offense so far. That's been the story.
I would expect him to take this into his own hands at this point.
He will on first down. And look for 4 yards. Well, another big play in this game. Defensively, Arthur Brown had 5 early tackles for Kansas State, then had that injury a few moments ago where he got twisted up trying to test that ankle out. He wants to get back in this ball game. He's not doing that for his cardio there. He just wants to prove he can play.
Yeah, well, that's a good sign that he's able to move around and run. But typically with those ankle injuries, you can run straight ahead. It's changing directions. Can you go side to side, plant and cut? That's where you really have problems with those ankle injuries. And I'm not really sure if he's ready to do that.
They'll run it wide on second down, and that'll be a first down for John Hubert. 11 yards and the first down for the Wildcats tonight.
Got a great block on the outside, too, by the receiver, Tremaine Thompson. Just a quick hitter, but Tremaine Thompson, you're going to see him at the bottom of your screen, 86 right there, comes down and seals, and then that allows Hubert to get to the corner.
Klein under center on first down. Play action. For the corner, and a great leaping grab for a first down by Chris Harper. 15 yards.
That's a good throw by Colin Klein. Going to the wide side of the field and throws it on the money. I mean, this is a tough throw for anybody. Just rolls out. Still not the ideal throwing motion, not the prototypical motion there, but got the job done.
It's an awkward delivery.
Yeah, it is. Like he almost like he's aiming the ball, you know, instead of really just stepping, setting up and stepping in and throwing.
Three in the pattern on first down. And again, finding number three, Chris Harper.
I guess you know what they say. It doesn't have to be pretty as long as it's effective. And it's effective. Look at the protection. He's got plenty of time to survey the field. Again, throws that out to Chris Harper on the outside. Chris Harper. Only four catches coming into this game. He was their leading receiver last year, so he's very anxious to get going in the passing game. Two in a row there.
Picks up 24 on that play. Best drive of the day for the Wildcats. Little jump pass into the flat. And wrestled down from behind. That's going to be a horse collar. John Hubert, as he was heading toward the sideline, had seven, and they got him from behind.
Man, Marcus Trice, just got to know where you are. Just let him go. You're already out of bounds. I mean, if he just lets him go, see the jump pass here and then just the speed of Hubert, but right here, you're out of bounds. Let him go.
Personal foul, defense, horse collar tackle, 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
And again, if he had just let him go once they went out of bounds, it would have been no penalty because he wouldn't have brought him to the ground. You let him go there, but watch, he just continues and continues and pulls him all the way to the ground. It's not a smart play by Marcus Trice.
Wildcats on the move. To the ground game, right side. And this time, North Texas does a good job of sniffing it out. Hubert held it check for a couple.
You know, Kansas State offensively, they still feel like they're a work in progress, even though they played so well last week against Miami. They wanted to come out here and be more physical than they were last week. They wanted to work on creating more big plays, and especially through the air. And they know that they can't grind it out every game like they did last year. Last year, 8 of their 10 wins were by 7 points or less. So they want to create some big plays through the air.
Klein completes it at the 9 and diving forward to about the 6-yard line. That's Tremaine Thompson, his first grab. A junior out of Jenks, Oklahoma.
I think they really wanted to work on their passing game. You know, going into next week's big showdown with Oklahoma. Last week, Colin Klein only threw 11 passes. He completed 9 of them, but only threw 11. So, you know, I think they really wanted to come out here today and work on some of their passing game and try to get that sharp for next week.
Hubert the deep back on 3rd and short. Goes to the up back, plowing ahead. Braden Wilson, the fullback. I don't know if he's got it. Going to be very close. Wilson goes 256 pounds. And he just got enough. Klein, meanwhile, on this drive, 3 of 3 for 46 yards.
And here's where he's really dangerous running the ball. You know, they just get him the ball and run the leads.
Yeah, this is typically where Colin Klein goes to work. Puts the hard hat on, ready to go. Hands it off. And again, good defense there. Ball. Mean Green, and the ball is loose. And picked up by North Texas. A rare mistake and a rare turnover by Kansas State. Marcus Trice, the guy who just had the bad penalty, makes the big play.
Yeah, he just ripped that ball out of there. Marcus Trice, and that's what you're taught. Once a ball carrier is hung up, the next guy in trying to rip the ball out. No whistle on the play, so the play was still alive. And then watch number 8 come in. Once they get him hung up, there's Trice, number 8. So they've got the ball carrier hung up right now, but watch him rip this ball out. He's, look at that, right there. That's what you're taught to do. They practice that all the time in practice, and now it creates a huge, huge big play for North Texas.
This first half has been very un-K-State-like. A turnover, and the time of possession has been dominated by the men in white, and a big run here. This is Jimerson, the freshman, 40. Stiff arms his way out of bounds at midfield. Alan Chapman, the last line of defense after a 45-yard scamper.
Wow, how about Jimerson? But look up front, look at the white jerseys. Everybody on somebody, and then look at the hole that Jimerson has to run through, and he just squirts right through there. A couple missed tackles, and now he's off to the races for a huge game. But I'll tell you what, this offensive line is controlling the line of scrimmage, and they're actually dominating this Kansas State defensive front.
Again between the tackles and plowing ahead for 5 more is Bird.
Going back to that last big play, Jimerson does a good job right there just squirting through the hole. Kansas State just not very sound right now in their run fits up front.
Again on the ground, and again second, third effort. They are just winning the battle on the line of scrimmage.
I mean, right now they are the more physical team. The North Texas offense right now is more physical than this Kansas State defense, and they're just taking it to them. And nothing fancy, they're just running the football right at them.
Arthur Brown, as you saw, back in the game, number 4. They need him right now. Bird tripped up near the line. Another impressive drive for the Mean Green. Incidentally, the last time North Texas defeated a ranked team, you got to go back to the early 70s when their coach Dan McCarty was a senior in college. And a timeout called by the Mean Green.
Timeout, North Texas. That is their second timeout of the first half.
7-7 our score with 6:01 to go in half number 1.
West Virginia rolls. Mike?
I'm going to tell you what, Kevin Marcus, that's a guy to look out for when you talk about Heisman hopefuls.
Well, he's going to put up huge numbers, put up big numbers last year, and now in the second year of Dana Holgorsen's offense, it's only going to get bigger and bigger, his numbers, that is.
And doing it in a bigger and better league in the Big 12 as Delgado makes another catch, 8 yards for the Mean Green. West Virginia, I think, really the two additions to the Big 12, West Virginia and TCU, I think that's about as well as you could have done as a conference in that situation to pick up those two.
No question about it. And both of them coming in as conference champions.
And you've actually got 3 reigning conference champions in this league. I don't know if I've ever heard of such a thing. That's Brown talking things over with Derek Thompson. Brown and Jimerson have already combined for 94 yards. Not much on this carry, though. And I do believe he's short. It's 4th down and about a foot. What do you do here?
I'm Dan McCarney. I'm going for it. I mean, your offensive line has been dominant this entire first half. Looks like he's going to kick it, though. You need it fourth and one. I think if you're North Texas, if it were me, you're coming in here to Manhattan playing against 15th ranked team in the country, I'd try to go for it.
They've got a guy with a good leg here in Zach Owen. And this would be from 45. Well, short, might have been blocked. It was. Looked like Vi Latui, the big defensive tackle, got his paw on it. More great special teams work by Kansas State. A kick return for a touchdown and a big block of a field goal right here. When we return, we'll take you to our Fox College football studio for a halftime preview. Kevin Marcus, thank you. A lot of great games tonight. A lot of big-time matchups. And I think a lot of people surprised at the score in this ball game.
Yeah. I want to hear his take on paying players myself. see what he has to say about that.
Line, play action. What a tuck and run. This is what he does so well. Game from about 7. But going back to that block punt, JC, all I see is a bunch of purple jerseys coming through.
Yeah, I mean, look at Latui 92 hits his elbow, but look at Ty Zimmerman 12, Justin Tuggle 2. I think either one of those guys might have got the block as well. I mean, they just completely blew that North Texas field goal protection unit to the ground.
Second down of the yard. Line again with a blocker in front and pass midfield to the 49-yard line.
All this is a lead. And Colin Klein now turns into a running back. And watch Hubert 33, just a lead blocker. You get the lineman Cornelius Lucas coming over folding, and now it's just a lead play. But now Hubert becomes the fullback, Colin Klein becomes the tailback, and you got an extra blocker.
Kind of weird saying Hubert's a fullback at 5'7", a buck 90.
Smallest fullback at times in the Big 12.
Deep ball by Klein, and he overshot him. Boy, he had Harper. That's the second time Colin Klein has had somebody open deep and couldn't find the mark.
Yeah, just rushed it. Double move on the outside by Chris Harper. You see the pump right there. Just rushed it. Just got to put a little more air under it. He knows that he missed that one. And those are the ones that, you know, if you want to be known as a passer also, as a good passer, those are the ones that you have to make. And I know he's working on his throwing, works on it diligently, but that's the part that's kind of missing right now.
Lyon will keep it himself and pick up about 3. It's hard not to make a Tim Tebow comparison, not only in the way he plays and the numbers he's put up, but when you sit down and talk to this young man, as we did yesterday, it's hard not to like this guy. He's such an incredible person and great personality.
Oh, no doubt. Definitely a great kid. I mean, all the kids that we talked to were good kids, very respectful, very intelligent. You know, he works on his game diligently, and like you said, I mean, he compares very favorably to Tim Tebow in the style of football that they play. Big, strong runners, but still, in the passing aspect of it, still has a little ways to go.
On third down, oh, he threads the needle on that one. Good-looking throw to Curry Sexton, the sophomore. And that'll move the chains.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that throw there. You just want to see him make the consistent throw. See, he just throws it right on the money.
You know, I know we've been making Tim Tebow comparisons. When I watch that slow-mo look at his delivery, actually reminds me of another former Florida quarterback and Heisman winner, Danny Werfel. That was the knock on Werfel. That slow delivery and release. Right on, right on. line. Over the middle again has a man, and this time it's caught for a touchdown. Tremaine Thompson for 38 yards. Well, that one was right on the money.
That's what you want to see from Colin Klein. And if he can make those throws consistently, watch out. Watch out. A defense is not going to know what to do with this guy. Great job freezing the safety and the linebackers, and then just throws it out over the top. And nobody there. Zach Ward, the linebacker's too short. Marcus Trice, the safety, is out of position.
The extra point is true, and Kansas State has the lead for the first time today with 2:24 remaining at half number one. 14-7 our score. Dan McCarty fired up. Wildcats on top, 14-7 our score. That man Colin Klein is heating up, and he had some help from Tremaine Thompson, our great hands of the game.
Yeah, there's Tremaine Thompson. He just runs right down the middle of the field, and the safety for North Texas, for some reason, you see him back there, Marcus Trice, he stays wide, and Tremaine Thompson runs right down the middle of the field. Great job of concentrating on that football and comes up with a huge touchdown for Kansas State.
Momentum has certainly changed in this game. Into the end zone and not returnable. With the new kickoff mark at the 35, we're seeing more touchbacks than ever, from 17% last year to 40%. Not a whole lot of kickoffs anymore in college football. And when you got a guy like Tyler Lockett returning, you could understand why nobody wants to kick it to him.
Well, they did, though. But, you know, when we talked to Tyler, he told us that one of his goals this year was to lead the country in kickoff return average.
Right.
I don't think he's going to be able to do that, though, because who's going to kick the ball to him?
Right.
You know, I mean, he's not going to have very many more opportunities.
North Texas already learned its lesson. Lockett returning one for 96 yards back in the first quarter. Dean Green back on offense. Catch before Power, the big senior tight end, is popped and dropped. Good job of holding out of the football. Arthur Brown in on another tackle. I've got 8 for that young man, and he's working on a bum ankle. Hand off, more straight ahead running, but this time Kansas State responds. Jimerson runs into a brick wall. A couple of purple jerseys there, including number 99, Javonte Boyd. Boyd goes 6'2", 297, a senior out of St. Petersburg, Florida. This defense last week against Miami had 5 sacks, forced 3 turnovers, 10 tackles for loss, and they're starting to heat up now. Third and short. Can't get there. Jimerson with about 3 purple jerseys in range, including number 50, Trey Walker.
Yeah, Trey Walker, good job playing off the block. Reading the play, knowing that it was a screen. They're trying to set up the screen outside. He's able to make that play.
Meanwhile, Kansas State using a timeout, 1:01 remaining, and a chance to put together one last drive before the half. Well, so far tonight for the Wildcats, it's been a couple of big plays. 96 yards by that man, Tyler Lockett. Averaged over 35 yards a return last year, trying to lead the nation this year. The passing game started off real slow, but Colin Klein right on target. And a beautiful grab by 86 Tremaine Thompson. And that's how we've arrived at a 14-7 score. The Wildcats leading the way. K-State's got Oklahoma next week. One of the games of the year in the Big 12 Conference. Directional punt. It'll sail out of bounds. They do not want to let Thompson return one. Well, tomorrow on Fox NFL Sunday, the Buccaneers head to New York to take on the Giants. The Cowboys try to remain unbeaten against the Seahawks, and the Redskins and RG3 take on the Rams or other regional action. It all begins with Fox NFL Sunday, the pregame show at noon Eastern Time, 9 a.m. Pacific.
About that Saints and Panthers game. Panthers defensive guys are a little upset, huh? They think that the Saints ran it up on them a little bit last year, trying to get some records and putting up a lot of yards when the game was out of hand.
Well, they need to pick it up. They didn't look very impressive against the Buccaneers in week one. Fly has all day. And throws it up for grabs and picked off by North Texas. Beautiful leaping grab by Will White, who was shadowing the intended target.
Yeah, that play just took too long. And when you're running a route with really only one guy in the route, and you roll the quarterback out, and everybody's reading the quarterback, and that's a long throw to make, and you just drop right under. That's Will Wright, the linebacker, just way down in coverage.
Well, Kansas State is typically one of the top teams in America in turnover margin. They have now given it away twice. Good field position for the Mean Green. Final 47 seconds of the half. Thompson on the run. And delivers a strike for the 45-yard line of Christopher Bynes.
Got to hurry up. The clock is still running.
They don't seem to be very...
Got a timeout left.
Well, this is taking way too much time. It took 24 seconds to get that snap off. And almost picked off. Boy, oh boy. It was intended for Teagarden. The terrific coverage on the play by Randall Evans.
Again, very similar to what we saw with North Texas getting the interception. This time, you know, Evans is running under. It's a long throw, and it takes too long. Lucky that Evans wasn't able to make that catch for the interception.
That could have been six the other way. Instead, it's third down and two. Thompson, pump fake. Look out. Sacked. K-State defense again coming up big. Meshack Williams.
Yeah, Thompson just held that ball too long. That clock's got to be going in his head. 1001, 1002, that ball's got to get out of there. Watch Meshack Williams, 42, fights off the cut block. Thompson's got to get rid of that football.
North Texas just 1 of 7 on third down this quarter, as the Wildcats defense has taken it up a notch or two. Meshack, a senior from Sylvester, Georgia. I like their ends, Williams and Davis. And of course, we've already talked about Brown and the linebacking core, and then a very good secondary as well. This has got a chance to be one of the better defenses in the league.
Oh yeah, they've got a lot of talent on this defense at every level. Talked about the ends, their linebacking core. Arthur Brown, Walker, Justin Tuggle, all very athletic. And then in the secondary, with Malone and Zimmerman, Alan Chapman at the other corner. They've got a lot of talent.
Fourth down at 7. Loose football. There's a scrum, still no indication from the officials. And that'll be the final play of the half regardless. An interesting first 30 minutes of this ball game. Two big plays for Kansas State. Outside of that, North Texas played some very good football as we sent it down to the field with Laura.
Coach, North Texas playing a physical brand of football, but you're able to put some points on the board to take the lead into the half. What finally worked in that scoring drive?
Well, we had a couple of intermediate throws that were successful, so we threw the ball a little bit better. Still haven't run the ball very well at all. Our special teams has kind of kept us in the ball game, and our defense up to this point in time anyway.
Thanks, Coach. Halftime in Manhattan with the score 14-7. Kansas State on top of North Texas. Now we take you to our Los Angeles studio for Fox College Football Halftime with Kevin Frazier and Marcus Allen.